Hi, everyone.
Hello. Start over.
So some stuff happened. Actually, we were talking about before the video, trying to recap what's happened in the last week. And it's kind of...
It's everyday.
Regular adult stuff, unfortunately.
Yeah. Unfortunately, yeah.
We have, we spent some time today talking about some of the stuff that we want to go do this summer.
Mm-hmm. Game planning,
mm-hmm.
What we want to do.
Mm-hmm. Because summers in Arizona mean get the f*** out of here.
Yes.
There's nothing to stick
we'll
around
have to
here.
Bleep that out.
There's nothing. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. There's nothing. It's too hot. It's just too hot to do anything. That's just what it is.
Even going to the pool, it's like
it is,
the water's like 90 degrees.
It's like a bath water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not refreshing. You
no.
Just, like, the only way it gets refreshing is if you go get in the pool and then stay wet and run into a house with air conditioning
exactly.
on.
Exactly. Pretty much, yes.
So, but the normal adult stuff gives us a chance that we can talk about Melissa's fear of dentists. Because the kids went to the dentist this week, which had been postponed a couple of times. And,
because Demetrius was sick, and then we put it off because it's expensive, not going to lie. No. But yeah, so we put it off, and so they went and just had a teeth cleaning and their x-rays and stuff.
And Melissa was sweating.
I was
for days. Like,
I was.
What if I know Demetrius has a cavity.
I thought for sure
I know
had a
he's got a cavity.
Because I thought the tooth didn't look right. I'm like, this doesn't look normal. So I think it's a cavity. I don't know. I'm not a dentist. Mm-hmm. I just was like, anything wrong with your teeth, you have a cavity. And I had quite a few cavities when I was a kid and quite a few bad experiences with a dentist.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a huge fear of the dentist anyway. And it takes everything out of me to take the kids to the dentist.
Okay,
like,
so let's back up. You go to the dentist's office.
Mm-hmm.
What is your mood when you first walk into the office?
I start getting all sweaty and clammy, and I'm irritated instantly. Like, I don't want to be there. And then, it's just, I'm just finding, trying to find reasons to get out of there. And trying to find, and I mean, you can ask Isabel. I was super irritated with the girl that was doing, the technician she was doing Demetrius' x-rays, because I didn't feel like she was being very nice to him, because he was having a hard time doing it. Like,
mm-hmm.
He had to bite down on this specific thing, and she was like yelling at him, and I'm like back in the booth, Isabella and Francesca going like biting my tongue, like, because I didn't think she was being nice enough to him, and then I get better once I'm there, but I literally looked up stuff all day long before the appointment, because I was positive he had a cavity, and I had gotten myself so freaked out, like, looking at the stuff that could possibly happen if you have a cavity, if you have to have it filled, you have to have a root canal, I mean, like, all this stuff. And then we go, and they do the x-ray, and then they clean it, his teeth, and the dentist comes, and he sits down, and he looks at Demetrius' teeth, and he goes, he doesn't have a cavity, and looks at me like, I'm nuts. He's like, he has no cavities, his teeth are great. I'm like, oh, what's his tooth? He goes, it's just worn down, because it's a baby tooth, and from where it happens,
mm-hmm.
But there's no their teeth look great. Both of them have no cavities. They're doing a great job brushing, everything's great, and I mean, I have a sigh of relief, but I'm still, like, every time I go to the dentist, like, I cringe.
So I wait every time the kids have to go to the dentist. I wait for the call from the dentist's office. Like, you need to come get your wife.
No, I hate the dentist. I really do. But I'm trying to be better for them, because dental hygiene is very important. And
oh, yeah, and they're salesmen too, right?
So yes.
Like, you're sitting there with the baby.
Yeah, and they're like telling me like, oh, well, the baby should really be seen by the time she's 1 year old. I'm like... Yeah, that's not happening. Like,
yeah, we're all over that one.
We're on top of that one. Three. That's the other kids went when they were 3 or 4. I'm not taking them. She had no teeth in her head. Sorry, I don't buy it. So, I mean, it is what it is. They have a job to do. They got to upsell. They're trying to get us to do different things, this and that. And I'm like, no, that's not going to happen. Nope.
So, and we're still in limbo, where we don't know if we're going to have to move or not.
Yeah, this place, our lease is up at the end of July. And last year, they sprung it on us that they wanted us to move. And we were like, I panicked and freaked out and was like, no, I don't want to move.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's like, because it's like the worst time to move.
Right before school starts. And it's in a school zone where everybody wants, we picked this school because it's a wonderful school district and it's a wonderful school. And everyone wants to be in this school zone.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a problem. So now it's like. Last year, we were going to go on vacation. It was all this random stuff that we had been like. Up
yeah, we thought and, like I.
We were for sure they were going to let us stay because they had let us stay the year before.
Yeah, so like we were going to go to Lake Tahoe,
mm-hmm.
or we did, but we found out, and I immediately messaged our Airbnb host, like, hey,
we might not be able to go.
We might have to move. I might have to cancel. Will you let me cancel without penalty? You know, like, started freaking out. And then the next day, we find out, like, no, they changed their mind. You guys can go ahead and
stay. Yeah, it was because I had, like, expressed when I called them. I said, listen, is it something? Because they send you an email because it's the property manager place. They're like, you have until July 31st to get out, you know, whatever, blah, blah. And it was like, it did. They gave us a long time, like a month and a half. Mm-hmm. And yeah. But I was like, but what did we do something wrong? And she's like, oh no, it's nothing you guys did. It's just they want to sell the place. And I was like, oh, okay. And she's like, why are you disappointed? And I was like, yeah, we kind of wanted to stay. And she was like, oh, I'm sorry, you know, really mm-hmm. nice about it. And then it was like a couple hours later, she called back and said, like, listen, you know, if the owner let you stay, would you sign another lease? And I was like, yes, like, yeah, like right now, we'll do whatever you want.
Yeah.
So and they ended up saying, like, no, you can stay. So we're not sure.
Asking them early mm-hmm. this year. Like, hey, if you're planning on selling,
just let us know. Like,
maybe we can move when school gets out, when everyone else in the neighborhood is trying to move. We'll actually have an easier time finding a place.
So, but we have not heard. That was like 2 weeks ago that mm-hmm. we called the property management place, and they called the owners, and they left like a message for the owners, and the owners just have not gotten back. So I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing.
Yeah.
I just automatically think it's a bad thing and we're going to have to move.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So. No. Not just that they're going to sell.
Oh, my God. Wilson's mind.
Not just that they're going to sell the house. Is that while we're here, they're going to come bulldoze it down.
No. Yeah. Pretty much. They won't let us out. Look, he was trapped in here.
Yeah. So, but some stuff's been going on with her. She's
learning.
Oh, I got this thing going on now.
Sippy cup time, mm-hmm. huh? You want to try
some? Yeah, you kind of like that water, don't you?
Yeah. Her feet. Yeah, look at her. She's like a pro.
Mm-hmm. She gets excited when it gets close to her, but then the water comes out. She's like, oh,
what is that?
What's in there?
I think she thinks it's going to be formula. That's what I was just saying. Like, I think she thinks it's a regular bottle. And mm-hmm. formula is going to come out. And then she's like, that's some, like, plain tasty formula just came out of that thing. I think you put too much water in that one, Mom.
Yeah.
Yeah, so she's just started doing this, like, yesterday mm-hmm. or Friday?
Yeah.
Friday. And then she's going to start this week. She's going to start solid foods. I'm going to start her on some rice cereal. I asked the doctor, and she said, anytime after 4 months, it's up to you. These are the signs. And she's got all the signs that she's ready to eat. So.
It's so great when they start eating regular food. It's like, even the cereal, it tastes like nothing.
Yeah.
And as soon as it hits that mouth, like, ah.
Oh, yeah, it's like, oh, it's so spicy.
So spicy.
She's like, what? I'm going to say that? She's staring at you.
Everything's just so spicy. The world tastes funny.
Yeah, so she's excited. She doesn't know. I'm excited for that. I always love that. So I already bought the cereal and everything. She's gonna try it.
Yeah, yeah. So, and well, the big debate this week, the big debate was switching formulas.
Yes, because I'm a worrywart. Like, and I asked the doctor, and I asked, you know, make sure. Because Dominic has been since she was born.
So from my perspective, here's what Melissa's like, what's the best one? What's the best formula? What's the best way, you know, to transition?
Yeah.
You know, all these things that go into making formula. And here's how my decision-making process went. That one's $30. This one's $18. How come we can't switch to the $18 one?
Yeah, he kept asking me, like, when are you going to switch it to the cheap one? The Costco brand Kirkland one. When are you going to do that? And I kept thinking, like, well, I don't want to switch her because I don't want to switch her just for money and then have her stomach get sick.
Mm-hmm.
But she's never had any problems with formula. And so I basically talked to the doctor and said, like, it's the same stuff. Like, literally, it's the same company that makes it. So don't feel bad about that. She said, if she doesn't like it and you have to return it, you make your husband return it because he's the one that wants you to buy the cheap one.
So the doctor's even against me?
She said, she goes,
I remember that.
Yeah, she goes, well, and if she doesn't like it and she gives you trouble about it, just make your husband return it because he's the one that wants to get her on the cheap one.
I'll turn it right back to her office. She's the one that said it was okay.
Yeah, but because I told her that you kept bugging me about it. If I said, well, my husband has been asking me for months, like, when can we switch her on the cheap stuff? And she's like, it's the same thing, but if she doesn't like it, I'd make your husband return it. Because he's the one that was all worried about the price of it.
Well, I'm like, because we talked about it too. It's like, I'm not just freaked out about how much the formulas cost. I guess you could say I'm like a wannabe prepper.
You know? You're just not as bad as
a kid. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm not like burying a rail car out in the mountains of Colorado or something, you know.
You have like ammunition stored somewhere.
Yeah, exactly. I was thinking, like, well, for $18,
for
$18, we can get like three or four things of formula and have extras around.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, it's true. It is. And, in the end, I ended up switching her, and it was like a long process because it's me. I don't make anything easy. So I added it to her regular formula a little bit at a time, and she took 3 days. And now, actually, to be honest with you, I think she's actually doing better on this formula than she was on the other one. She doesn't spit up as much.
Yeah.
And she doesn't have, you know, like, she doesn't have as bad a gas. So there's that, too.
Well, that may not be because of the food she
eats. That might be because of you.
That might be family.
She's like, I don't know what I want to do.
This might be genetics. I'm
comfortable here. Yeah. So, but anyways, it ended up being fine. It was. But, and the doctor said, like, it's not that big of a deal because they're in the same, like, category. It's not like I'm switching her from a soy-based to a, you know, a milk-based to a soy-based or something. Mm-hmm. They're both milk-based. So, and like she said, they're literally made by the same company. They just don't tell you that. So,
yeah.
It's okay. Aw, Bubba.
So... So that's pretty much what's going on. Demetrius has a
field trip
on Monday.
Yes, Monday he'll be going to the Arizona Science Center. It's in Phoenix.
I love the name Science Center.
Like, is she gonna talk now?
Yeah, like science, like it's just like we used to do science stuff.
It's sciencey.
Yeah, it's science. Science. I don't know, some rocks.
It's like stuff. I mean, any. I don't know. How to explain it. I guess like if you're familiar with the one in the Bay Area, it's like the Exploratorium or. Like
the OMSI
in Oregon, or any of those other ones. It's like they do science. You can do experiments there. They have like little, they have the human body one set up that he liked. It's like you can go inside and this is what the stomach sounds like. This is what the heart sounds like, and you can pick a giant nose. And I don't know. So he's excited, but he gets a little nervous because I think he's disappointed that I can't go on the field trip as a chaperone. So. Because I have the baby, so but he has to get used to it.
He'll be okay.
Yeah,
he'll be okay.
Yeah.
And then next week they're both going on field trips on the same day.
Yeah, I don't like that at all. I don't like them to be on field trips anyway because they have to ride on the bus and it's a long, and you have to go with some other parent who's got to keep an eye on you. And what if that parent don't know what they're doing? Because in my eyes, nobody does. Not paying attention and they lose them. No, not so much with Isabel because she's just going to the movies. So, I mean, how hard, I guess you have other things to worry about, like the giggling that's going to take place and all the flirting with the boys that are there.
Yeah, I know. We're not going to talk about that right now.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, so then, and then he's going to, which is going to be really fun, he's going to like the Diamondbacks, it's like a school field trip day they have. And they and it's like all these different schools go there together at the Diamondback Stadium in Phoenix, and they do like all kinds of like they have a petting zoo and food and games and all kinds of stuff. So he gets to go do that. So he's super excited about that. So he gets his two field trips within a week of each other. They must have just like not had anything planned and be like, we got to plan something.
Yeah, we got to do some stuff because like school gets out in 6 weeks.
Yeah, yeah, and also they have this week coming up at the end of the week, which. Neither of my kids is really very fond of, but it's like field day where they go play games like all day and run around and have popsicles. And I mean, they like it, but it's hot here. And it's always like it's going to be like 100 degrees this week.
Well, I mean, it's finally, the weather's been amazing.
Yeah, it's
been like
beautiful.
In the low 80s and everything's nice. And as soon as the school has something planned outside, boom, 100 degrees.
Yep, exactly.
It'll be 100 degrees on Thursday.
Yeah. Have fun with that. Yeah, and they're always like, make sure you send a lot of water. I'm like, how much water can I send? And they're like a whole gallons of water. I can only send one water bottle. Jeez, how much can I send?
I mean, we saw earlier, it's like that gif of like, you know, the definition of an Arizona summer. It's like that angry sun. Just like, wah.
Yeah, it is. It's like so hot. And don't give me that, but it's a dry heat because it's still hot.
Yeah.
It is hot.
Well, it's like, you know, it's supposed to be a dry heat until monsoon season comes.
Then it's
freaking 1,000 degrees of humidity outside.
Dominic loves humidity.
Yeah. Oh, we do so well.
Yeah, we all do so well with that. Yeah, so that's pretty much.
Yeah, so that's what we got going on this week. You know, normal stuff, normal Melissa nervousness stuff that was changing the formula.
Also goes along with nervousness is that we're going to take family portraits.
So So now there's like this pressure, right? Like, gotta get the kids' haircut.
Yeah, gotta get everything
gotta
set
get
up.
Clothes
yeah.
and stuff like that.
I
like,
figure out what to wear.
Fancy, but not too fancy.
Yeah, exactly. We had to go this weekend and look at places to take the pictures outside. So we went and looked at a bunch of different like community.
Yeah,
parks
we went around. There's a bunch of new neighborhoods east of here.
Okay.
And
look.
Oh,
So we're looking for somewhere to find a place to mm-hmm. take family pictures.
And that neighborhood, it has a bunch of parks where they're like little fireplaces mm-hmm. with chairs around them and stuff.
And nobody uses them, I bet.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the neighborhood's still under construction.
Yep.
So we're going to sneak in for an hour or so.
And take some pictures
out there. I got someone that I work with that's a good
photographer.
Photographer. So, but yeah, that's what we got going on. Some exciting stuff.
Mm-hmm. The dentist is always exciting.
All right, Frankie. We're going to end this video.
Say bye-bye, Francesca.
Say bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.